okay, got back in here today after the bye week. You know, look, we got four games left. I said this last week, and all four of them are important. So this will be a big week for us.
Your reaction to the fake injury allegation?
You know, I really can't get into that at this point in time. I will say that I don't think our team did anything wrong.
And the player did have an injury, right, Coach?
He's got an injury, yes.
I'll ask, but maybe you can't answer since you can't say much. Was there an explanation that they thought the coaches were seeing advising him to do something?
I haven't had any communication, so I really don't want to comment too much on that.
Two-part question, I guess. First, do you already have your starting quarterback decided for this week?
Yeah, Andy will start.
Is there any school of thought with Jameis Winston that since he's under contract next week that at some point you want to get a look at
him? I think we'll evaluate everything as we, you know, finish out these last four games, you know. But I think, you know, Andy's done some good things. I think we've got to do a lot of other things around him to help him, and that includes, you know, us as a coaching staff putting everybody in better positions.
When you had a chance to review the offense, especially I guess in some of these fourth quarter situations and red zone, what is it that you feel like?
I think the biggest thing we've got to do is we've got to take advantage of the opportunities that we have, and we got to be able to score touchdowns in the red area. I think that's, you know, you go back and look at some of the losses in these close games. We've had opportunities in the red area to score touchdowns, and we haven't. And I think that's an area that we've got to, you know, look at to improve. And without going into all the details that go into it, you know, I think that's where our focus needs to be.
I don't know how to ask this question without it kind of coming out kind of dumb, I guess. But like, you guys have had some issues closing out games this year. What's the difference between a team that can't close games and a team that maybe doesn't consistently throughout the season?
Yeah, it's hard to say. I mean, you look at some of these teams that, you know, play a lot of these close games, and one year they, you know, do a really good job of winning those games, and the following year they don't. And it's the difference between, you know, being a playoff team and not a playoff team. You know, why that is. Look, I think it's not just the end of the game. It's what leads up to the end of the game that you know, where you have opportunities to take advantage of some things. And when you don't do that and you allow a team to kind of hang in there and hang in there and hang in there, you know, you give them opportunities at the end of the game. And so when you have an opportunity to put a team away, you got to be able to put them away.
When you look back at some of those opportunities throughout some of these games, why do you think maybe that's went their own way? More often than you guys would
look. Yeah, look, I think ultimately it gets down to our ability to go out and make plays on the field. And I feel like, you know, in each one of these games, you know, there's a handful of plays that we have an opportunity to make that we haven't made that you know, kind of makes a difference between winning and losing. And this is a, you know, it's a highly competitive league. And so the difference in winning and losing is a small margin, fine line. Look, we're going to continue to evaluate it as we finish out these last four games. You know, because I still feel like there's a good football team in there, and feel like we can win a lot of games.
And as I know injuries are part of the game, but you haven't had minor one for a long time. How much can you quantify how much you've missed?
Well, look, I mean, he's a Pro Bowl player, you know. So anytime you lose a Pro Bowl player for that extended amount of time, it hurts your team. I think it allows us to do some different things defensively in terms of what we do coverage-wise. You know, I do think that, you know, guys like Alante Taylor have been able to step up in his absence and have done a nice job. But yeah, anytime you're missing a guy like that, it's tough.
Yeah, look, the way the division is shaped out, I mean, is it tough right right now, show sort of balance, looking ahead to the future and, you know, trying to focus on still having a shot at.
No, I think, look, you know, I think our goal, as it is every week, is to go out and try to put a winning performance out there. And that won't change ever. You know, the goal is to go out and win.
Probably not ideal to have the bye week this late with the way the season's gone, the injuries, but what were some of the benefits that you've seen from the players now that they're back in?
Well, look, number one, I mean, I think just getting a chance to hit the reset button just a little bit. You know, we played 13 weeks in a row, and we're one of six teams that did that. It's hard playing 13 weeks in a row in this league, and you know. So I think number one is getting a chance to hit the reset button a little bit, focus in on the things that we have to do to improve over these last 4 weeks, and continue to try to, you know, win games. And so I think that's where our team's at. I got no challenge with the effort of the players. I think our players are playing really hard. I go back and look at showed the team today the fumble that Cam caused in the Tampa Bay game. I mean, that's a hell of an effort play, and so guys are playing hard. You know, we just gotta execute a little bit better at certain times. I don't know that there's one thing I can put my finger on. You know, again, you know, we continue to put ourselves in, you know, situations where we have opportunities, you know, and look, the number one thing you have to be able to do is put yourself in a position that you have an opportunity to potentially win a game. And so I think we've done that, but we haven't executed well enough. You know, in all three phases of the game, you know, to take advantage of those opportunities and produce enough wins. And so that's really where we're at. But if you don't ever put yourself in those positions and give yourself those opportunities, then, you know, you got no chance to win. So, you know, right now, I think, you know, as of the other day, I think we were like ninth in the league in scoring differential, you know, and for a 4-win team, you know, you'd think there'd be some games in there that you just, but in every one of these games, we've had some opportunities. So I can't think of many where, you know, the game was over in the first half. You know, we continue to go out there and fight and battle and give ourselves chances. We're just not, we're not finishing as well as we need to. Well, I don't really look at it nearly as much as how we're going to close out these games. I look at the opportunities that we have to take advantage of during the game, where you don't put yourself in those positions. You know, we've got to do a better job both offensively and defensively on third down. We haven't been as good as we need to be. We're middle of the pack in terms of that. That's been an area that, you know, over the long haul, offensively, we've been very good. That's been something that over the last few years, we've been pretty good defensively. So, you know, I think converting third downs, which will help us in terms of time of possession, because, you know, we're towards the bottom of the league in terms of time of possession. I think that plays a big factor in you know, when the opposing offense has the ball for more than you do, they get more shots on goal. And so third down will be a big part of that.
Said a lot, and I've heard it for years around here. You are what your record says you are. Does that make your stomach turn a little bit, or does it feel fair, like to be there at this time?
I mean, what's fair? You know what I mean? Yeah, it's disappointing. It's frustrating, because, like I said, we've had chances. You know, I can think of a handful of games that a play here or a play there turns the game and. You know, we're not having these discussions. And so One, the positive is we keep putting ourselves in those positions and giving ourselves a chance. The negative is we haven't overcome that hump.
When you say you're looking at things you can do better, were there specific conversations about how we make more use of Alvin Kamara, even more than the offense?
Yeah, we talked about that. We've talked about that. You know, I think, look, Alvin's a good football player. And so we have to find ways to allow him to be the playmaker that he's been for us in the past. And so, yeah, there's been discussion about differing ways of doing that. And so that'll be something that we will focus on, yes.
The third warning call has been dissected ad nauseum over the last week. Looking back on that, after you had a little time to kind of sift through it, any further thoughts on that at all?
Well, I think I said the other day that looking back on it, I wish that, you know, that I'd run the ball there. But any of those situations that don't work out, there's always going to be the second guessing as to why didn't you do this or why didn't you do that. The gist of the matter is, you know, we've got to get that first down. It's third and one. You get an opportunity to, you know, worst case scenario, we're going to take 2 more minutes off the clock. So, that bothers me.
You mentioned taking advantage of the opportunities and that. Like, what can you guys as coaches do to kind of take better advantage of those opportunities?
Well, I think some of it is we've got to make plays when they're there available to make plays. And I think some of it is us just from a schematic standpoint putting guys in the best position to be successful. And so we haven't been consistent enough in being able to do that. And I think that's, you know, offensively, defensively, and in the kicking game.
Are you looking to make a lot of differences schematically, or are you just trying to execute?
I think we got to look at some of the things that we're doing schematically. And a lot of it is just our execution, and maybe the execution is how we're teaching it, you know. So I think that's the good thing about, you know, our program here is that we're all, like, you know, nobody's trying to point the finger anywhere. We're all, you know, trying to get it fixed.
Yeah.